sounds shocked. I did not know you were a gun owner.
I'm a gun owner. Tim Wong was a gun.
I did not know that.
So even if she doesn't have a gun, she has someone that she is paying to be near her at all times with a gun.
If somebody breaks in my house, they're getting shot.
Under Joe Biden, 85,000 undocumented children have gone missing.
And Joe Biden's administration doesn't know where 85,000 of those kids are.
It's like these kids that are coming over with men and then are never seen again. Gavin Newsom signed the country's toughest law banning digitally altered political deepfakes.
So do you intend to seek legal action, whether on Elon Musk or any of the proliferating
deepfakes? The law asserts that many can seek injunction relief.
It's called the First Amendment, you bitch. Also, isn't it funny how fast they can create and pass a bill when it serves their party? It seems like they're really effective when they want to be. Hello, everybody. You are listening or watching Chatting with Candace. I'm your host, Candace Horbach. Before we jump into the episode, we're going to check out our coffees. Who has bought us some coffees? Norman. Thank you, Norman. Thank you, Wanda. And thank you, I think it's Tri-G. Thank you so much for all the cups of coffee. All of that goes right back into the podcast, so I sincerely appreciate it. If you want to contribute to the podcast, go to chattingwithcandace.com and click that little link that says buy me a coffee. It all goes right back into the show. We're doing lots of traveling, lots of in-person. We are going to a big libertarian event, the Resistance event. This will post before. So if you're in DC, you can come see me, Gerard Michaels, Kelsey Sheeran. We are going to be at the Resistance. Let's find out what the actual name of this massive conference is. Jointheresistance.org. We are going to be there on Sunday. Huge lineup. We're going to be running media. So if you see us, come check us out. We'll be recording. We have a cool, exciting thing that we are launching over here. It is called ELO, E-L-O. I think if you have been following me for a while, you get the nod there. So it is going to be a sexual wellness community, and it is going to have a lot of content as well as products. And we are starting off first with our book club. Now, I know that might not sound like your thing, but I highly encourage you to sign up if you want to come check it out. Join the book club. It is a really good group of people. Go to elo.club. We will link that below. We have our three books already selected for October. I cheated and started early, and I'm already almost done with all three. The one that I will give you a sneak peek to is The Way of the Superior Man by David Data. I am trying to get him on the show. Every single man, young man, adult man, grown man, needs to read this book. It will save you so much unnecessary drama and worry. And it is just an incredible book. And I think every woman that is in a relationship with a man needs to read this. So I finished that in one day. 10 out of 10, highly recommend. So go to elo.club and join our book club. And we're going to be doing monthly Zooms with everyone that is engaged and reading all of the books, and it's all free. So go on over, sign up. I will see you there. Can't wait. We are blind reacting to the news this week because my beautiful producer did so much work in sending me all of the notes, but I have been traveling and have not had time to look at them. And we're just going to find out what's happening together in the world. So we're starting off with presidential race news. What the heck could be happening? Let's find out. We have a new Trump campaign. This is going to be good. Let's watch it together.
Now they have pledged to carry out the largest deportation, a mass deportation, in American history. Imagine what that would look like and what that would be.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
So I don't understand. Are there really people that just want an open border? Like, are there real American citizens that really want an open border? Anyone can come in at any time for any reason with anything. That seems like a terrible idea, like an absolutely terrible idea. I don't know. What do you think? I think if you come over illegally, and especially if you're committing crimes, you shouldn't be here. Sorry. See ya. There's no second chance. You shouldn't, I mean, if you were lucky enough to get here, then you better be on your best behavior. That's all I'm saying.
We can do all of this and more, but patriotic New Yorkers must get your asses out to vote. How to get up? Get a gallon. Harry, get up, Harry. Harry, get your fat ass out of the couch. You're going to vote for Trump today, Harry. Get up, Harry. Come on, let's go. Let's go, Harry.
Who's Harry? Do you think he's going to take New York? I mean, I see, I don't think it's impossible. When was the last time that New York went red? Let's check that out. Last time that New York State was red was 1984 for Ronald Reagan and 1980 for Ronald Reagan. So back to back. We shall see. That'll be a massive, massive victory. And does that mean he would have it in the bag if he gets New York? We shall see. Kamala wants trespasser shot. What?
I'm a gun owner. Tim Walz is a gun.
I did not know that.
If somebody breaks in my house, they're getting shot.
Yes, yes. I hear that. I hear that.
Probably should not have said that. But my staff will deal with that later.
She seems a little bit tipsy, right? Like just a little bit. Like maybe we had a martini before meeting Oprah. And also, you're going to tell me Oprah sounds shocked. I did not know you were a gun owner. You're telling me that Oprah, one of the richest people in the entire world, doesn't have armed security. So even if she doesn't have a gun, she has someone that she is paying to be near her at all times with a gun. So let's not pretend that these people are anti-gun. They're just anti-gun for you. And I think Kamala has made several comments in the past, and you guys can look this up because the internet is forever, where she's very adamant about taking your guns away. So if they say assault weapon, like every weapon is technically an assault weapon. That's the whole point, right? Whether it's a deer or an intruder or whatever. So I believe her. She probably has a gun. I don't know how many times she's used it, but I think that she will always have a gun, and people like Oprah will always have guns. They just don't want you to have guns. So she's trying to be relatable, but we're seeing right through you, Kamala. Trump-Iran email hack. The situation explained.
U.S. intelligence accusing Iran of election interference in this country. Iran allegedly hacking the Trump campaign, sending stolen information to the Biden campaign, what they allegedly sent. And authorities have said Iran also tried to hack into the Biden campaign as well. Pierre Thomas on this story as well tonight.
Tonight, the urgent investigation. Federal officials claiming Iranian hackers sent stolen information from Donald Trump's presidential campaign to political operatives associated with President Biden's campaign. National intelligence and security agencies, including the FBI, saying that in an attempt to influence the election, Iranian hackers sent unsolicited emails to members of Biden's team that included stolen, non-public material from former President Trump's campaign. Those emails, which were sent in late June and early July, right before Biden dropped out of the race, reportedly included vetting documents for potential Republican vice presidential candidates. The agency is saying there's no information suggesting that those recipients replied, but it's unclear tonight if any of them opened or forwarded the emails.
Iran hacked into my campaign. I don't know what the hell they found. I'd like to find out. Couldn't have been too exciting. But they gave it to the Biden campaign.
Tonight, the Harris-Walz campaign is condemning any foreign election interference. The Harris campaign says it's cooperating with authorities and acknowledges that a few individuals were targeted on their personal emails with what looked like a spam or phishing attempt.
U.S. intelligence officials say Iran tried to hack into both the Biden and Trump campaigns, but was only successful against Trump. And David, authorities are warning that not only Iran, but also Russia and China will be expanding their election interference efforts as we get closer to election day.
And we know we'll stay on this, Pierre Thomas,
tonight.
Can we
just go back to electing people that don't want the job? Do you know what I mean? I think that's the major problem is now it is such a cash grab that if you become a politician, you end up, I don't know, 10xing your net worth easily by the time that you're out or a few years after you get out. That seems a little bit, that seems like a trap. Like you're just attracting really shitty people that way. But I don't know how you get around that. Everything is digital. No one's using blockchain yet. So we're going to get hacked, and a lot of people's minds are mush. So they're going to see something and think that it's the truth and not do any digging. I just We need to put lie detectors on everyone. How about that? We do that for the debate. Everyone is live strapped to a lie detector, and we also have a professional that's there that's reading body language, and maybe we have some kind of third source of like a bullshit detector, and then that way in real time, or maybe we use Neuralink. We can speed up this process. We need Elon on it. We get Neuralink attached, and we can just we can track in real time when people are full of shit, and then we can just like dunk them. Like the floor will come out and just like dunk them below. See you later. Thank you for playing.
You know, speaking of people coming in, we've had huge problems abroad. Obviously, Iran has hacked your campaign.
How about that?
And apparently, the Harris campaign has been the recipient of some of that. They say they haven't. How do you respond to that?
Well, the FBI said they have. It's gone over to the Democrats, the information they hacked. I don't know what it can be, but I can, you know, it's not a nice thing to happen. I call it Iran, 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 just like Russia, Russia, Russia. We had to put up with that for 2.5 years. And after 2.5 years, I could have told them the first hour, but after 2.5 years, and they know it was a hoax, but this isn't a hoax. This is real. I mean, this is real stuff. They hacked my campaign, they spied on my campaign, and they gave the information to Kamala. So when is the grand jury meeting? I'd like to know. Is there going to be a grand jury? We went through 2.5 years on a hoax. This is not a hoax. This was found by the FBI. I congratulate them for that. But this is not a hoax. They spied on my campaign, and they gave the information to the Harris campaign.
Yeah, well, they're the first people to spy on your campaign, too. You've had issues
with
that.
Well, we had Obama and Biden spying on my campaign, too.
I mean, you just got to start locking people up. There just needs to be a consequence. It's just like toddlers. If they think they can get away with everything, they will, and they will keep escalating, so there has to be a consequence. Why does this not apply to the people that are running our country? I don't know. Maybe because they are above the law. This one is really interesting. I saw some stuff regarding all of the missing children, and people will be so quick to write it off as QAnon and all of that. It's not true. Look at the numbers of human trafficking and all of the missing kids that disappear every year. So these are real numbers. There are amazing charities and nonprofits that are working on this. But most migrant children who worked long hours, were released to sponsors, have little support aside from health and human service departments. We found reports of tracking to hotline increased by 1,300% over the past 5 years. Well, this is just the abuse and neglect. If you look at, let's see if I can find it, the amount of missing kids that come over the border, they just come in with basically a coyote and no one checks in on them. So they come in and then they're gone. So what do you think is happening? They're coming over with men too. They're not coming over with moms. They're not coming over as families. It's like these kids that are coming over with men and then are never seen again. It's really disgusting. So when you say that you want open borders and you think you're doing the right thing and you think that you're being, you know, with humanity and you're an empath and blah, blah, blah. Like, no, you're actually part of the problem because you are letting these monsters bring kids in and they're going to be doing terrible things to them. Let's look at this. Increase on missing migrant children under the Biden administration. Under Joe Biden, 85,000 undocumented children have gone missing. 85,000. We don't know where they are. He doesn't know where they are. So when you want to defund ICE, you're literally taking resources away. They are the primary department that deals with human trafficking. So it has been rebranded in this really nefarious way that seems anti-human and that they're separating families. ICE is the number one department to save these kids. So again, you want to defund the police, you want to defund ICE, you're hurting kids, you're hurting innocent people. So this is just nonsense. 85,000 people. So let's keep that border open because guess what? Human trafficking is one of the biggest industries in the world. So let's make sure that we don't stifle that. Former New York City COVID czar exposed. Exposed New York COVID czar had sex parties. God. What is wrong with these people?
I actually was the one who convinced the mayor to make it a man game.
Like, New York City found out that you're having sex parties during COVID?
Yeah. Yeah, it would have been real bad. We went to some like underground like dance party like underneath the bank in Wall Street. And we were all rolling, we were all taking Molly and everybody's high. And I was so happy because I hadn't done that in like a year and a half, like a year or whatever. And but I was looking around being like, I wonder if he sees me living in Midland. Because this was not COVID friendly. The only way I could do this job for the city was if I had some way to blow off steam every now and then. You know, kind of sneaky about it because hotels didn't want people gathering there. Because I was like running the entire COVID response to the city. My wife and I like had one with our friends. Uh-huh. Like in August of like that first summer. So we rented a hotel. It was fun. We all like took like, you know, Molly and just like, it was like 8 or 9 of us and then 8 to 10 of us and we're in a room and everybody had a blast because everybody was like so pent up. Uh-huh. Because it had been like, everybody was just like stuck together and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And sometimes it isn't so much about like industry executive, some of it's just something about like bodies being close to each other, right? Just being like naked with friends.
Was that like when everything was locked down?
But it was like the summer of 2020. So like walk around the streets and you'd be outdoors.
Did you have like any mandates
in place? There wasn't any restrictions on gathering. Like you could actually gather people. The hotels didn't want to have parties, but they weren't gonna like.
Yeah.
It's so funny. It's like because I did all this like deviant like sexual stuff while I was like, you know, like on TV and all this stuff.
Yeah.
And people like, aren't you afraid? Aren't you embarrassed? And I was like, no, actually, I'm like really like I love being my authentic self. So the way we do it in public health is we make it very uncomfortable to be unvaccinated. I don't expect your education to change your behavior. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna make it really hard for you to do your job. You can't get a job. You can't go to a restaurant. You can't go to school. It's like, I'm just gonna get vaccinated.
So was it technically like kind of forcing people?
Yeah, that's what you do. You force people by making it really uncomfortable.
Whoa. The cognitive dissonance. Listen, I'm not judging the sex parties. Have fun. Do your thing. You're all adults. I don't think anyone, right? It's fine. It's totally fine. I don't think that that's a problem. What I do have a problem with is you can't eat outside and you're forcing people to get a jab. But then meanwhile, you're having these massive sex parties with all of your buddies. So we're pretending that we can't eat outside. Otherwise, you're going to get super sick and die. But you can swap all of these bodily fluids inside of a hotel room and it's totally cool. What the heck? And why does it always have to be the people that are into atypical sexual behavior that come and get outed? Come on. You're giving everyone a bad rep. It's not the sex parties part, people. And that's what everyone's going to focus on is, oh my gosh, see, everyone that likes weird sex is a terrible person. No, he's just a terrible person who happens to like sex parties. Yeah, the forcing of the vaccinations is bonkers. So they'll go back and they'll say that they never forced anyone to do anything and that you had choice the whole time, but you don't have choice when everything is made so wildly uncomfortable and you can't participate in normal reality. You can't go to a restaurant, you can't go to school, you can't go to work, you can't travel without these things. But yeah, we didn't force you. Jail. They should all be in jail. California AI ban. California Governor Gavin Newsom signed the country's toughest law banning digitally altered political deepfakes on Tuesday, following through on a vow to act after rebuking Elon Musk for sharing a doctored video of Vice President Kamala Harris. The new California law, which will take effect before the November election, channels rising alarm about artificial intelligence capacity to disrupt the elections by sowing misinformation, with votes increasingly confronted with deepfakes images and auto-impersonating candidates. Musk, who owns X, stoked the debate when he shared an AI-altered video of Harris in July, drawing Newsom's public promise to prohibit similar practices. Quote, I could care less if it was Harris or Trump, Newsom, end quote, told Salesforce CEO Mark about the conversation on Tuesday. It was just wrong on every level. Well, that's kind of bullshit because I guarantee if it was of Trump, he wouldn't have said shit. And also, isn't it funny how fast they can create and pass a bill when it serves their party? It seems like they're really effective when they want to be. So all of these policies that aren't getting passed, I don't know, maybe to help the drug problem, to help the homeless problem. That's really interesting. That's insolvable. We can't do that. We can't even get public toilets so that people stop shitting on the street. That's going to cost $1 million and 15 years worth of infrastructure, but we can pass this bill super quick because we have a candidate and we cannot lose.
I, Kamala Harris, am your Democrat candidate for president because Joe Biden finally exposed his senility at the debate. Thanks, Joe. I was selected because I am the ultimate diversity hire. I'm both a woman and a person of color. So if you criticize anything I say, you're both sexist and racist. I may not know the first thing about running the country, but remember, that's a good thing if you're a deep state puppet. I had 4 years under the tutelage of the ultimate deep state puppet, a wonderful mentor, Joe Biden. Joe taught me rule number one, carefully hide your total incompetence. I take insignificant things and I discuss them as if they're significant. And I believe that exploring the significance of the insignificant is in itself significant.
Talking about the significance of the passage of time, right? The significance of the passage of time. So when you think about it, there is great significance to the passage of time, and there is such great significance to the passage of time.
Another trick is trying to sound black. I pretend to celebrate Kwanzaa, and in my speeches, I always do my best Barack Obama impression.
So hear me when I say, I know Donald Trump's type.
And okay, look, maybe my work addressing the root causes of the border crisis were catastrophic, but my knowledge of international politics is truly shocking.
The United States shares a very important relationship, which is an alliance with the Republic of North Korea. It is an alliance that is strong and enduring.
And just remember, when voting this November, it is important to see what can be, unburdened by what has been.
That was amazing. See, they said it's a parody, though, and I think that if you're acknowledging that it's a parody, you can't make that illegal. That's free speech. I do think it's a problem if you're trying to make it pass as it being real, and that should be illegal. But if you're saying it's parody, by all means. Let's look at the Newsom video.
Hi, I'm Gavin Newsom, the governor of California. This is a message for the people of America, given in my authentically recorded non-AI voice. Thanks to my leadership over the last several years, California has become a world leader in extremist left-wing governance. My policies were so effective that almost 1 million people are now fleeing the state every year. We even ran out of U-Hauls. During the COVID pandemic, I locked everyone in their homes and shut down businesses for months. Not the French Laundry, though. That's my favorite restaurant. Last year, I cleaned up the dangerous, messy streets of San Francisco, you know, because Chinese Communist President Xi was coming, and I really wanted to impress him. He's my boss, after all. This year, I signed legislation that allows me to take custody of your kid if you refuse to give him artificial hormones and chop off his genitals. Because if you don't do that, you're a bigot, and bigots shouldn't be allowed to have kids. I've also led the way in green energy by banning all cars that don't run on electricity. Then I banned almost all the electricity. This is smart leadership. On my watch, the cost of living and homelessness have skyrocketed. Schools are failing. Drug dealers and human traffickers are pouring across the border. And poop has covered the sidewalks of San Francisco. This is the positive, joyful vision we offer as Democrats. That's why I'm enthusiastically endorsing Kamala Harris for president in 2024. She'll do to the country everything I did in California. Anyway, I'm California Governor Gavin Newsom, and I approve this 100% real message, which is a recording of my voice without the assistance of any AI whatsoever. This isn't a deep fake, and you can rest assured that it isn't, because I just signed an unconstitutional law outlawing deep fakes. No one would dare violate it. Thank you, and science bless America.
That is amazing. Aside from the little bit at the end, is there anything that was said in that that wasn't true? And this is posted by the Babylon Bee, which is a parody account. So again, you know that it's meant to be funny. To make that illegal is kind of, it's bananas. But is there anything that wasn't true in there? I don't think so. Gavin Newsom legal action against Elon.
I think Mr. Musk has missed the punchline. Parody is still alive and well in California. But deep fakes and manipulation of elections, that hurts democracy and the integrity of the system and trust. And we believe in truth and trust. And we think this law is sound and will be upheld in the courts.
So do you intend to seek legal action, whether on Elon Musk or any of the proliferating
deep
fakes?
Well, the law asserts that many can seek injunction relief. And I just signed the law. I just signed 32 other bills on housing. And I haven't had a chance to review the specific lawsuit around a conservative blogger that seems offended by our law.
It's called the First Amendment, you bitch. P. Diddy. Let's skip to P. Diddy. 1,000 bottles of baby oil sure is a lot of baby oil. It's a lot.
Sean Diddy Combs has been arrested in New York City, NBC News reports, citing a person with knowledge of the investigation. He was arrested in the lobby of a hotel, according to a representative. Diddy's attorney, Mark Agnifilo, issued a statement to NBC News saying, "We are disappointed with the decision to pursue what we believe is an unjust prosecution of Mr. Combs by the U.S. Attorney's Office. Diddy, he said, is an imperfect person, but is not criminal. To his credit, Mr. Combs has been nothing but cooperative with this investigation, and he voluntarily relocated to New York last week in anticipation of these charges. Please reserve your judgment until you have all the facts." Diddy's attorney adds, "These are the acts of an innocent man with nothing to hide, and he looks forward to clearing his name in court." E! News has reached out to the music mogul's attorney as well, but has not heard back. Per NBC News, it was not immediately clear what charges the rapper-turned-music mogul was arrested for, but it comes amid a wave of lawsuits filed against him, alleging sexual assault and an ongoing federal investigation. The federal investigation was made public in March when federal agents executed search warrants at his properties in Los Angeles and Miami. A source familiar with the investigation told NBC News in March, "Investigators interviewed several people in relation to allegations of sex trafficking, sexual assault, and the solicitation and distribution of illegal narcotics and firearms." The warrant to search Combs' properties came from the Southern District of New York, NBC News previously reported. On September 9th, Diddy was ordered by a Michigan judge to pay over $100 million to Derek Lee Cardello Smith, who sued the rapper for allegedly drugging and sexually assaulting him in 1997, according to court records viewed by E! News. Following the judgment, Combs' attorney said in a statement to E! News that Cardello Smith is solely looking to defraud the Bad Boys record founder and stated in part, "Mr. Combs looks forward to having this judgment swiftly dismissed." For more updates on this story, visit eonline.com.
Now, while 1,000 bottles of baby oil is not illegal, it is a lot. Is this an actual video from there? It can't be. And listen, he's maybe got a lot of friends. That part I'm not as concerned about. I know people throw all sorts of parties. He just wants to make sure everyone's slippery. But I think there's a lot of other people coming out that are saying that they've been assaulted by him. And it's a big number. When they ask Diddy about the 1,000 bottles of baby oil.
What? Huh? Oil? Who said something about oil, bitch? You cooking?
The end of that is so good. So Nikocado Avocado is, I guess, a real person. Popular TikToker Nikocado Avocado, that is a terrible name, has created a whole lot of confusion online after claiming his weight loss was fake and calling fans stupid for believing it. For context, Nikocado, I'm just going to call him Avocado. Avocado made a name for himself by amassing 4.5 million TikTok followers for his food content. Some of his videos reached in the millions, including the one that showed him blending, drinking various fast food items, reaching 87.4 million views. Earlier this month, the foodie, turned his channel to share an announcement that he had dropped 250 pounds over the last 2 years and that all his food videos were pre-recorded as a social experiment. Fast forward to this week, Avocado shared a clip of himself at his original weight, calling fans stupid for believing that he conducted an experiment online. So let's look at the weird avocado video first. Number one.
I don't have good news to share with you today. I'm actually really triggered. Let me tell you why. It's actually your fault. So let me break it down for the low IQs out there, which is actually most of you. I made a YouTube video and I said, I'm 2 steps ahead. My whole life is premeditated. It's calculative. It's manipulative. My life has been a social experiment. Joke's on you. I'm actually really smart. And what was the result of that video? Millions of people believed it. Y'all have the IQs of a bag of rocks. I can literally dye my hair blue and say it's always been blue, and half y'all will believe it. Yes, because I just acted gaining 250 pounds. Who in their right mind does a social experiment gaining 250 pounds for 5 years in a row? Y'all are so stupid. See, yes, see this double chin? Yes, I acted this out for 5 years in a row. For what? For clicks? We've all been played by this evil genius. Oh my God. I literally typed up a Batman monologue and read it on camera. I'm scared for society, actually. Okay? I'm a little afraid. Y'all need to go to school. Learn something. Think outside the box. Don't believe everything you're told, including from me. And yet y'all believed it. That's actually scary.
I'm so sorry I'm making you guys watch this. Blame David. Let's look at the skinny video now.
Yes, it's really me. I am not AI. I am not a clone. I am a real person. And it's me. There are currently people taking my Instagram stories or my Twitter posts and uploading them here onto TikTok, pretending to be me. This is my only TikTok account, and it is verified. The other Nikocado Avocado pages or Nicholas Perry pages are not me. Anything you hear from them is not me.
That's clearly doctored. That's definitely a filter. Anyone that believed that he was that skinny guy is out of their mind. Why are you guys watching this? 84 million of you. Why are you watching that guy? He's eating poison. He's morbidly obese. He's not very nice. Start supporting conscious creators. Learn something. Get off your phone. That is crazy. My mind is blown when I see creators like that. Influencers, whatever you want to call them, like that, that are so wildly successful, that are just toxic and they're rotting your brain. If that's what you're watching, just delete the apps. Go touch grass. Pick up a book. I don't know. Don't spend your time on people like that. Speaking of people that create content, Mr. Beast is being sued. Let's check him out. For what?
And popular YouTuber Mr. Beast and Amazon are facing a lawsuit over a new reality competition. Five contestants say the show wasn't what they thought it was going to be and that they were misled from the start. ABC News' Eva Pilgrim has more.
Whoever leaves the circle last wins $500,000.
Mr. Beast, a 26-year-old multimillionaire and YouTube megastar, now under fire. His production company sued, along with Amazon, by the contestants of his new reality show.
We're curing 1,000 people's blindness.
The class action lawsuit claiming the Amazon Prime show exploited the labor of the contestants, alleging sexual harassment and a hostile work environment. The show, a partnership between Mr. Beast, Jimmy Donaldson, and Amazon Prime Video, marketed Beast Games as the biggest reality competition series ever, with 1,000 contestants competing for a $5 million cash prize, the biggest single prize in the history of television and streaming. But now five of those contestants claiming the show didn't provide fair wages or even bare minimum legal working conditions. Many are still awaiting their promised reimbursement.
There was a lot of control over their sleeping arrangements, over the food, when and where, whether they or not they could go to the bathroom.
The lawsuit detailing what the contestants call unreasonable, unsafe, and unlawful employment conditions. Writing the show only allowed them to be fed sporadically and sparsely, fostered a culture of misogyny and sexism, and had insufficient medical staff to attend to potential and actual injuries during the production. There were several reports of injuries. Court documents, including a copy of a manual titled How to Succeed in Mr. Beast Production, that states, really do everything you can to empower the boys when filming. Help them be idiots.
The very first question, I think, here is, do game show contestants, particularly in the Los Angeles area where there are a lot of game shows, do they qualify as employees under California law?
And ABC has reached out to Donaldson, his production company, and Amazon about.
Well, the answer is no, you're not considered an employee. And that's the same for a film. So you would be an independent contractor at that point, and then you're not you're not allowed, not allowed, you're not promised food or breaks or anything like that. You're there to do a job. I'm not saying it's right. I've been on sets where I was on set for 16 hours and they provided a bag of chips and the pay was flat. I didn't get overtime or anything like that. There were no break rooms. There wasn't sufficient time to really have breaks. And if you did, it was in a really shitty cold room. Definitely not a great working environment, but I mean, that's kind of the nature of the beast. So I don't, again, I'm not saying right, it's right. Maybe there does need to be a little bit of reform there, but I don't, you're not getting paid minimum wage, you're a performer. Mr. Beast is launching an unhealthy school meal. He's launching it with Prime, and we all know that Logan just loves any kind of cash grab. He'll just do it for the money. If you look at his NFTs, you'll just know how he sees business. But yeah, we have childhood obesity that is through the roof. Let's look that up. Hey Siri, how many children are obese? Currently, 42.4% of adults and almost 20% of children 2 to 19 years old are obese. 20%. From 2 to 19, and you're going to launch a box that has a sugary coconut drink, probably filled with a bunch of trash, chocolate, pizza, turkey sticks aren't bad, Fiesta nachos. You are in a position to create really amazing change. You can do it, and you're choosing to just make more money and to make something that looks colorful and exciting to kids, and you're going to poison them. So you're poisoning your audience. You really care about them. You're very grateful for their support. It's bonkers. Man is arrested by a robot. Didn't they make a Will Smith movie about that? We know how this is going to end.
Taking a closer look at a dramatic East Lubbock standoff where multiple shots were fired and one person was injured.
39-year-old Felix De La Rosa was wanted for a parole violation. That's why officers tracked him to the hotel. But when he fired shots, they called in the Lubbock County SWAT team. At one point, we saw and heard him fire at a bomb squad robot. Take a listen. It sprayed tear gas into De La Rosa's hotel room. Initially, De La Rosa tried to fight the robot, even throwing sheets and what looked like towels at it, but that didn't stop the robot from deploying gas. We watched as De La Rosa crawled out of that window and onto the ground where the robot pinned him until officers took him into custody.
Well, this is one of those things that seems like a really good idea. You're protecting, you know, SWAT team members, police officers, creating a little buffer, a little bit of space. That seems like a good idea. It seems like this robot only has gas and the ability to kind of pin you, which also could end up being a problem. But we're steps away, weeks away from that being an armed robot. Seems like a really bad idea. And then also you're taking the human element out of it. Like, there needs to be that risk so that you can properly assess the level of violence that may or may not be necessary. If you have a robot, I feel like it's going to be a lot easier to have excess force because you're just dehumanizing that process a little bit. Seems like a bad idea. We've been warned 1,000 times, but we just keep progressing for the sake of progress. This is crazy. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad this one is in here, if it's what I think it is. Abortion is a complex issue with Charlie Kirk. Oh my goodness. Let's see if it's what I think it is.
Abortion is murder and should be illegal. Well, what does fetus mean?
A fetus is in utero.
What does fetus mean in Latin?
What the f-? I'm sorry, is this a language class?
It means little human being.
His smile is very creepy. Okay.
Smiling is creepy?
No, your smile specifically.
Got it.
But let's go back we're losing track here.
No, but is what species is the fetus?
The fetus is not a species yet. It's technically classified as a parasite until it is viable.
So,
no, I want to talk to you about something very quickly.
I can't legally get past that. Are you saying a baby is a disease or a tumor?
A parasite is not a disease and a tumor. Those are not the same thing. A parasite is defined as something that cannot survive outside of its host. A baby, before it is viable, cannot survive outside of a woman's womb.
Got it. So let's extrapolate that.
It is not a living organism.
Are old people with Alzheimer's and dementia that are being assisted every day, are they parasites?
No, they're not parasites. They're human beings who are on the brink of death.
Got it. So my
four-month-old
that requires mom's breast milk and requires daily changes and feedings cannot survive without its own. is my four-month-old a parasite?
Your baby can breathe on its own. Your baby can drink water from its mouth to its stomach.
But it cannot.
Your baby can eat food.
Can it hunt? Can it gather? Can it reason?
A four-month-old cannot feed itself, so that's completely inaccurate. And if a four-month-old is drinking water, it will actually be malnourished and die. So you literally need breast milk or you die. And even that, talk to any woman that has breastfed. It's not always easy. They don't even know how to do that. There's latch problems. There's swallowing problems. The idea that if the baby can't survive without a host, then that makes it not a baby. It makes it a parasite is nonsense because honestly, until they're about two, they absolutely need a human to stay alive. But let's keep watching.
But that's not what qualifies something as being a living organism.
Being
a living organism simply means can you survive outside of a womb, outside of your host?
Got it. So I just want to make sure I'm clear. Why does that then equate to moral viability?
It equates to scientific viability.
Why? Under what standard?
Because it is not alive, and you are advocating for the rights of something that is not technically a life.
Got it. So what?
Not alive?
While sacrificing the needs of the human woman who is alive.
Got it. So, but a mom can survive.
Yes.
Without the baby in her.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Yes.
The baby cannot survive without the mom.
Yes.
But a mom cannot survive without her lungs. So it's not her body. It's in her body. It's not her DNA, so it's not her choice. So it's a...
It actually is directly her DNA.
It's...
It is 100%. It's 50% of her DNA.
Half her DNA.
Well, that girl didn't win. That girl did not win. And then personal attack just makes her look stupid. I mean, you're there to debate. Debate, don't personally attack him. That makes no sense. I thought it was going to be the clip where he was saying if his 10-year-old daughter got raped and got pregnant by the assailant that he would have her carry the baby to term. At least he's consistent. I think everyone knows his stance on abortion. He's very religious. He's very conservative. At least he's consistent. I don't agree with that stance. I don't think most Americans agree with that stance. It's obviously, it gets a lot of eyeballs, and I think it makes people think that people are more extreme than they are on the subject. I don't understand the obsession over this. We've talked about abortion a couple of times. My opinion doesn't matter. I know what I would or wouldn't do. But if you're going to say that you need to make it completely illegal to where if a little girl, a 10-year-old, gets raped, that she is now being forced to have the baby because two wrongs don't make a right, I think that that is retarded, and I think that is a simplification of a very complex issue, which is there is no right solution there. And no matter what, you're destroying a life. And I think in situations like that, most people are very sound. They're going to say, no, that 10-year-old's life is more valuable than a couple of cells at that point that are going to be a baby. Yes, it is a baby. Not yet. It's growing into a baby. But yeah, I think his stance on that is wild and really extreme. And again, as much as I hate it, I was like, at least he's consistent. But don't let the internet fool you and think that that is most people. I really don't think it is. I would venture to say 90% of people would disagree with his stance on that. Let's end on something fun. This is amazing. And this is probably one of the only reasons why I would go to China. This is adorable. Oh my gosh. Who's a good boy? So the Shanwei Zoo admits that they painted dogs white and black to make them look like pandas. The zoo initially tried claiming that the dogs were a unique breed of panda called Panda Dog. It was later discovered that the pandas were Chow Chows who were dyed white and black paint. That is the cutest thing ever, and someone needs to do that for Halloween. If you have a Chow Chow, you need to turn it into a panda for Halloween. That is so friggin' cute. Also, didn't they take all their pandas back? San Diego, I think, might have just gotten re-leased some pandas, but didn't they take almost all of their pandas back? So why aren't you just using actual pandas? What did they do to the pandas? Well, now we have to do a deep dive into that. We got to find out where all their pandas are. But that is so cute. All right. Well, I hope you liked this episode. For all of you that are still hanging in there, thank you. We will be back next week with some more topics. We'll have interviews. Next week, we are launching an episode with Gerard, Bridget Fetisi, and David Landau. It's going to be amazing. And so check that one out. We will see you next week. And maybe I'll see you in DC on Sunday. I'm going to be there again with Gerard and Kelsey. Come say hi and pop on camera. See you later, everybody.